What's up internet, welcome back once again. I am Manish from RebellionRider.com. Today in this PL SQL tutorial we will learn the second function in collection method series, and that will be exist. Let's start the tutorial with a quick intro of the collection method exist in Oracle database. Collection method exist checks the existence of an element at a specific index in a collection. If it finds the specified element, then it returns true, otherwise it returns false. Let's do an example to understand the concept. So here we have declared a local nested table. This is the same nested table which we created in PL SQL tutorial 51. Let's move ahead. Here we have initialized our nested table by inserting three entries using the collection variable col_var_1. So now we have a nested table which has data at index 1, 2 and 3. Let's write the execution section. In this section, we will see how to use collection method exist to find the existence of the elements. Here in this code, we are checking if we have anything at index 1 or not. If collection function exists returns true, then it will execute the first part of the if-else statement and will show the data. Otherwise, it will execute the else part of the if-else statement. Let's execute. Here is our result. Before moving ahead, let me take a quick second to ask you to subscribe if you haven't already. Also, make sure to smash that thumbs up button and like the video. Your every single like means a lot to me and keeps me motivated for doing more such videos. Having said that, now let's move ahead. That is how you can check the element at a specific index without traversing the whole collection. Along with checking the element at an index, you can also take advantage of this function in inserting the data into a cell of a collection, and that too without overwriting the already existing data. Suppose you want to insert a data into a specific index, but you are not sure whether that index is already holding some data or not. In case if it is holding any, then you don't want to overwrite it. Let's see how we can do that. But before that, let's close this script output and delete this execution section. Done. In this code, we are checking if we have any data stored at index 4 using exist function. If there exists an element at index 4, then the first part of if-else statement will execute, which will show the data stored in the index. But if there is no data at index 4, then the else part of if-else statement will execute. In the else part, we have three statements. First statement is a simple output statement with a custom string. In the second statement, we are extending the collection using the extendCollection method. We will discuss this collection method extend in another video. Anyways, in the third statement, we are inserting the data which is Spider-Man into the collection at index 4. Let's execute the code and see what happens. Here is the output. So these are a few of the ways of using exist method. Now let your creativity fly and find out various other ways to use this function. If you find something new, then comment down below and let me know. Meanwhile, give this video a thumbs up. Also, by sharing this tutorial, you can help others in learning and our channel in growing. So go ahead and share this video on your social media. This is the tutorial on collection method exists in Oracle database. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.